Thank you. you said a little while ago, this is the course where caution is going to pay.
Yeah, absolutely. You see, typically,
traction strip.
No.
Do you have to wear a med alert?
You should.
I can't get up.
I think that all of our riders should be wearing a med alert out there today. So it's interesting, Splinter, that it glazes over a little bit out there as well. It actually gets slipperier.
Yeah.
As the riders continue to ride. They don't wear in, I like to call it a blue groove.
Yeah.
Eventually, the riders who are taking the hot line keep taking the same hot line, and you can see the groove that they're building into the course. There is no blue groove out there today.
In a lot of places, what it's doing is it's just getting polished. It's the
exact opposite of the blue groove, actually. Because when you talk about the blue groove, what you're talking about is the elements from the tire casing that get left behind in the road. That's kind of what creates that. Here, what you're doing is you're sheening it out. It's almost like you're zamboning the corners out there.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's take a rubber squeegee and run it across the turn.
This might be the first time that the word zamboni has ever been used at a cyclocross race. I'm not sure.
I'll give you credit
for
it.
Yeah, thanks. Typically, Richard Freeze beats me to the punch on that stuff.
Oh, Sam. Almost a model.
This kid's a scrapper, no doubt about it.
But got that bobble and got it back on big time momentum in a hurry,
and then throws a bunch of watts at it. So this kid is a gamer, no doubt about it. I can tell now I'm going to be a big Sam Rosenberg fan over the next few years.
Yeah.
And that's Sam. If you're watching on the big screen, or if you're watching, excuse me, on the World Wide Web, you're seeing Sam in the red and white jersey. If you're here with us in Bend right now, he is pretty much on a victory lap at this point.
I think he's left the zip code of everybody else.
Yeah, we're not seeing any chase behind him in this camera shot right now. So as he hits what we call the stairway to heaven, there is his main competition. So Sam in very, very good shape. He actually has time to stop and have a cliff bar right now. A frozen cliff bar he would be able to eat and digest, I would think.
Yeah.
said about Sam Rosenberg, just take that and transfer it over to Cameron Beard, because that kid had one hell of a ride out there today.
He did, and one of the things that I think may have helped with that is Cameron lives here in Bend, and I'm sure came over and checked this course out yesterday, had a pretty good idea what he was going to see, which is why it looked to us like he had radar for so many of the hard spots.
Yeah, well, congratulations, Cameron, and our apologies to everyone out there for misidentifying. Yeah,
I'm most used to seeing Cameron in the Bend Endurance Academy kit. Which,
well, and the balaclava did not help.
No,
yeah, that's right.
And new sets of numbers for everybody.
But credit where credit is due. Cameron Beard. Now, is Cameron the kind of rider that will be gearing up for Nationals as well?
Oh, yes.
I have to think so.
In fact, the Bend Endurance Academy concession sale, all the food and drink that they're selling today, Cameron is still associated with the BEA, and so don't buy some food, send this kid to the Nats.
I think you and I will be heading down there.
we may need to make an apology.
Well, Cameron, great ride and continued good luck here in the 2013-14 season. You're going places, my friend.
Oh, yeah. Well, and as I said, there's this whole group here with Cameron, Lance Hedet, Javier Colton has just come on like gangbusters this year.
Where's Javier from?
He's a Bendite.
Okay.
I think usually rides in a Sunnyside Sports kit. And one of our Boneyard riders finishing.
So these are 2-3 men that we are wrapping up right now. These guys probably could have handled a third lap.
Yeah,
because this is a pretty advanced. This is an advanced category, to tell you the truth. This is one step away from joining our elite level. So if this is baseball, you're looking at AAA
right
at this point right now.
And I think the two-lap decision was made early to make sure that we could keep the race on schedule
fully
today. And one of our Deschutes Brewery riders coming in now with the red sleeves.
A lot of factors at play out here for our officials. Obviously staying on schedule because when we start running the men's line, we start the night, we're racing at pitch, things like that. So you have to keep everything on schedule.
Start finishing riders early on the bell line.
Gotcha.
So, kind of regardless of your drivers, then we'll finish early, and then we'll